If you're looking for a quick full body workout routine and you have some fitness equipment lying around like kettlebells and dumbbells, this is the right video for you. We're gonna look at 9 different exercises and this whole protocol is gonna take less than 30 minutes to be done. So in case you want to do a little progression after your workouts or squeeze in a workout on a tight schedule, this workout will do it because it can be done in less than 30 minutes. Most of these exercises are done in 2 sets from 8 to 12 reps each, and we have 1 minute, so 60 second rest in between. In case there's a different exercise like the unilateral kettlebell lunge, it will be specified while presenting the exercise itself. Let's go. First exercise is dumbbell bent over row. It is a great exercise that emphasizes the pulling motion using the weight of the dumbbells against gravity.
For the bent over row, we will grab the weights from the ground, keeping our spine in neutral position. Feet are shoulder width apart, toes slightly outwards. We are keeping strong foundation through our hamstrings and lower back, also squeezing the core. Lift the dumbbells by pulling back with your hands until your elbows reach behind your back and create an angle of around 90 degrees, then slowly release back and repeat. Key points are to focus on activating your core, breathing properly, keeping your head in extension of the spine, and stabilize your shoulders. This exercise mainly targets the muscles like latissimus dorsi, trapezius, radial deltoid muscle, and scapular retractors.
Then we go on to the dumbbell bench press, for which you're obviously going to need a bench. This is a great alternative for the regular barbell bench press with weight plates.
Lay down on the bench, pick up the weights and position your elbow slightly inward, having around 90 degrees in the elbow and 70 in the shoulder. From here, squeeze your chest and core and push the weights up and overhead. Then slowly get back and repeat again. Make sure you activate your chest muscles and push through your shoulders. Lock your elbows on the way up when you lower the weights. Make sure you do eccentric part in controlled manner. The dumbbell bench press mainly activates your push muscles like triceps, pectoralis major, and front deltoid muscles.
Next up is the dumbbell Russian twist. It is just as the regular Russian twist, but with the difference that we are adding a little dumbbell weight to further increase the resistance and activate our core, especially the lateral torso rotating muscles.
Sitting down on a mat, pick up one dumbbell and lift your legs. Flex your knees slightly and start twisting, bringing the dumbbell to the right, then to the left. Make sure you squeeze your core and keep your legs off the floor. Do quicker reps on this, but make sure you control them with your core so the dumbbell doesn't pull you to one side. The key points are straight spine, legs are off the floor, and activate your obliques. The twist mainly activates the core muscles such as rectus abdominis, internal and external obliques.
Next up is the kettlebell push-up. Just as the regular push-ups, great for indulging your chest, front shoulders and triceps, we're doing the same pushing motion. The only difference is that we're not gripping the full floor with our palms, but we're only using the kettlebell handles to do the push-up on, which will definitely challenge our shoulders and activate the triceps and chest muscles more.
To start off, place 2 kettles on the floor and set yourself in a plank position gripping their handles. Hands are shoulder width or slightly wider. From here, you do slow eccentric movement, then push back up using your chest, triceps and front shoulders. Try to focus on keeping your neutral spine, head is an extension of the spine and hips are leveled while the core is tight. This exercise mainly targets your push muscles such as pectoralis major, front deltoids and triceps, brachii, but also stabilizes the shoulders.
Fifth exercise is the dumbbell lunge. We're basically switching legs, doing right to left dumbbell lunge, so pick up the weights that you feel comfortable and stable with and the weights that you can do this exercise with an optimal posture.
Pick the weights up and take a big step forward. You can place the feet wider apart for more stability. Squeeze your core, glutes and quads and lunge down by flexing your knees to lower your body. Then step back with the front leg in reverse, stepping up with the left leg and lunge again. Try to keep a neutral spine again, activate your core and knee goes in the same direction as your toes. Lunge is a great way to strengthen and activate your core quadriceps, especially the frontal part, gluteus muscles and hamstrings.
We go on to the fifth exercise, which is the lateral dumbbell raise. This is one of my favorite exercises for building wider shoulders and more functional ones. It is using the lateral hand abduction, in which we're lifting our arms horizontally, mainly indulging the middle head of the deltoid muscle.
exercise, we pick the weights up, keep regular stance in neutral spine. For extra stability, we widen our stance. The main movement we are performing is abducting the hand, so lateral shoulder flexion. The best results and minimal shoulder pressure is when we slightly flex our elbows and perform the reps with our arms slightly forward and not in the same line as the shoulders. We raise the dumbbells until we reach shoulder height and lower back slowly, then repeat it again. Key points are head and spine in a neutral position. We activate and squeeze our core and lift with engagement of our shoulder muscles. The lateral raise targets mainly our deltoid muscles, made up of three cuts, the front, middle, and rear delt.
Kettlebell deadlift is by far one of the most popular and used corrective exercise here for someone who hasn't yet developed perfect mobility to do an optimal barbell deadlift. It is a great way for beginners to activate the hamstring muscles as well as core and stabilize the lower back too.
Pick up the kettlebell in normal stance, feet are hips width apart, toes slightly outside. Slowly lower it down by pushing your hips back, slightly flexing your knees but doing most of the movement by hinging in your hips. Once you lower the weight, inhale and make sure you are keeping your back straight. From here, push up and extend, mainly activating your hamstrings and lower back, then slowly go back and repeat. Keep your spine neutral, activate your core, and bend your knees slightly. Push through your feet. The deadlift, as a foundational exercise, develops your whole body, but this version mainly activates the hamstrings, lower and middle back muscles.
Next up is kettlebell lunge to unilateral stance. Now this is a little bit different and is done with two sets on each side because it's unilateral. What we basically do is lunge down with the kettle and then go up, flex our hip and knee and extend ourselves completely, then go back in the kettlebell lunge. This will further activate your knee, ankle and hip stabilizers.
To start off, pick a kettlebell and place it on your shoulder. Take a big step with your right foot forward and do a lunge by flexing both of your knees, lowering your torso, then push back. From here, you lift the left leg up, push your knee up, indulging your abs, and slowly release your left foot back to repeat the lunge again. Squeeze your core, try to keep your shoulders leveled, neutral spine, and stabilize the knee. The kettlebell lunge to knee lift will strengthen and activate your hip stabilizers, hip adductors mainly, but also strengthens your glutes, hamstrings, and abdominal muscles.
Last but not least is the shoulder overhead press, but done with kettles, so kettlebell overhead press, which is a great alternative for the push press or the overhead press we do with a barbell to build bulkier and wider shoulders.
Pick up both kettles and place them on your shoulder. Push your elbows slightly lateral and inside to form an angle of 45 degrees in the shoulder. Keep in a neutral spine. In normal stance, activate your abdominal and push the weights up. Lock your elbows on the way up and then slowly lower the kettles on your shoulders. Then repeat the process. Make sure you lock the elbows up and flex your head a little bit forward to make sure the kettles are overhead and not forward or backward, as this will cause strain on your shoulders. For someone with perfect shoulder mobility, head flexion would not be necessary. The main muscle targeted here is the deltoid push muscle, both front and middle delts, as well as the abdominal muscle, spine stabilizers, and triceps muscle.
That's around it for today's workout. Make sure you tailor the reps, sets, and the rest time to your own specific fitness goals and needs, and pick up the weights with which you can do 8 to 12 reps with an optimal posture. I'll catch you in the next one.